At Intel, Gordon Moore was definitely, I did not report directly to him, but I was kind of three levels below him and attended many, many meetings with him. And I was really impressed by his humility, really a humble person, very smart, very gentle, never spoke except when he had something really good to say. Really, really good model of a scientist that a humble scientist that was very, very good, and always had the big picture, not just the little picture. Andy Grove was a superb manager, really superb, most highly disciplined. Could drive you nuts. There was one time, I wanted a meeting with Andy and. I said, I called the secretary, I said, I need 1 hour, I need to go with stuff. She called back, she said, Andy will see you for half an hour, and it's gonna be in your office. It's 8 o'clock. He shows up at 8 o'clock. At 8:30 sharp, he gets up and goes. And we covered everything in half an hour, of course. So, because he made, yes? So, but he was the guy that was, we're gonna be better than. We have something good to conserve here. Andy was the guy that said, we'll be the last one in Silicon Valley to turn the lights off. But he was also the guy that had the discipline to get Intel out of DRAM and out of basically all memory so that they could focus on microprocessors. And that was the most brilliant call that I think anybody has made. Very, very gutsy, very courageous. Really, really courageous. Because microprocessors at that time were nothing. Nothing. Yes, yes, yes. Federico had left to Zilog, but Ted Hoff was there, yes. Oh, he's a great guy. Really, really great guy. He was in my lab. I had a development facility at on Kiefer, I mean, around Santa Clara. And he had these ideas about how to make DRAM cells that he used my lab. It turns out that this was 1981. And this is what people are using today now, just getting into using that technology in DRAM. So he was 25 years ahead of his time. And of course, it didn't work for us because it was, the idea was great, but we just never took it very seriously. So we definitely had a lot of crap to go through, and I could tell you that around 1990, when we were between 5 and 10 years old as a company, and me as a CEO for 5 years, we were not making it. We were not making it, and the board was getting a little bit restless, let me know about it. What neither I nor the board realized at the time was this chasm, the fact that between the early adopters and Main Street adoption, there is this period of years where nothing happens, and you're saying, what am I doing wrong? And you're not doing anything wrong. The only thing that you need to do is to accept that you're in the middle of the desert. The desert is 7 years long to cross. How are you gonna live through it, okay? That's the savior. Once you get to that, and once we understood that and started taking action, and once the board got it, then they got off my case. But also over time, I became a much better manager and much less of a micromanager. When you're a small company, you micromanage everything, which you should. You should. No matter what people tell you about micromanaging, you need to know the details. You need to sweat out the details. But at a certain point in time, you need to let go and let other people, blossom through the organization. I would say we certainly had some very rough patches. We had, in 2001, we laid off 40% of our employees. We were manufacturing cards in the United States, and we couldn't do it. We couldn't compete. And, this was our invention, our technology, and we were getting creamed because we were paying $14 an hour, and our competitors were paying $2 a day. to assemble in China. And we had to shut down all manufacturing here and lay off, you know, 40. We were 1,000 employees. We went down to 400 to 600. And that was very painful. And we had to really restructure the entire company. But we came out of it stronger, of course. It was the right decision. In consumer electronics, when you have something good and inexpensive, you can make an impact today on a very large number of people in a very very short period of time, which was just not possible 5 years ago. 5 years ago, the world was not global. And even that transformation has happened kind of sneaked up on us. You know, China with a huge trade imbalance is just one indicator. But, you know, manufacturing all over the world. It's not just manufacturing, it's development, it's innovation, wherever it is. I mean, we have design centers in India, in Israel, in Scotland, in Japan, and here. And you wouldn't know it. It's like they're all here. When I have a young guy, you know, that is, you know, very energetic, you know, an entrepreneur, and he wants to start a company, I try to explain to him or her that we are a startup company and that there are opportunities to start up here with all the resources that we have, but at the end of the day, he should go for it. I mean, if that's what he really wants to do, he should go for it, and if it doesn't work, don't feel bad, come back. You know, he'll be more valuable as an employee. He would have learned the realities of, what's good for the goose is good for the gander. You can't claim to be an entrepreneur and, you know, the next guy that wants to be an entrepreneur. Now, I would not advise just about anybody to become an entrepreneur, because if you don't have it, you're going to flounder. And people don't understand, most people don't understand how difficult it is to succeed as a startup, how stacked the odds are against you. Almost invariably, you fail. And it's quite rare to succeed. And to achieve that, you need to make tremendous sacrifices and be very, very focused. And be a glutton for punishment. And don't crack under stress. But sometimes the best thing about starting a company is you don't know what you don't know. And because if you knew it, you may not start. So it's good. I mean, you can't read about it in a book. You got to do it, you know, to get the scars. Really, I mean, if you see a picture of somebody with scars on their back, it doesn't tell you what it hurts. You got to have the scars.